Hilary DeVay set up her own small business 14 years ago.
When I started my business, I sold my house, I sold my car. In the first 3 years, I made my first million.
Her determination paid off. Today, Hilary's empire turns over nearly £100 million.
I put everything on the line and therefore failure wasn't an option.
Every year, 600,000 businesses cease trading in the UK.
Passion doesn't necessarily create profit.
Hilary DeVay is going to help two small businesses whose owners are out of their depth.
Your body language is all wrong. I'm being honest with you now, my credibility's on the line here.
You never even asked them, would you be interested? I did the job for you, look.
Right, right.
Hilary has to make them see that business is all about the bottom line.
Do you know what your accounts read last year?
I don't know, actually.
Yeah, it's bloody irresponsible of you.
Now the business inspector is set to put them straight.
I'm going to give them such a shake-up today that by the time they get back in that car and out my gates, they'll realise they will care.
When Hilary DeVay started her small business, she had a plan to make it big and stuck to it. Now she wants to help other British businesses do the same.
The problem with a lot of small businesses is they get to a point where they simply just don't know how to grow. And sometimes it does take somebody to come in from the outside and say, you've got to do X, Y, Z.
Milton Keynes florists Donna and Anne are cousins who started their business 4 years ago after studying together at evening school.
We enrolled in a college course in Moulton.
Every week on a Wednesday night, yep. We achieved our National Certificate in Floristry, Level 2, with lots of distinctions, actually.
They specialise in cheap bouquets and funeral sprays and chose a name to reflect their personalities.
Good afternoon, leave it out. How can I help?
Your ex-husband
Steve came up with it. He said something like, leave it out, girls. And we went,
that sounds good.
They work their green fingers to the bone, but when it comes to money, their heads and their prices are all over the place.
If you've got a budget, my love, then we can always work to it.
We don't get a lot of passing trade here, and when people come in, we get quite excited because it's quite nice to have more work to do.
There's no financial gain. We're not gaining financially, but we do come in and we drink lots of tea and we laugh and we joke and we put a smile on other people's faces. We're on this constant quest to upskill.
We need someone to tell us, how do you put this, this, this and this all together and become this fantastic multi-million pound florist? Yeah. You know, how do you do that?
Exactly.
Donna and Anne's business doesn't pay them a wage because it's not making enough money. Can the business inspector fix Leaf It Out's financial troubles? This morning, multi-millionaire Hilary DeVay is at home and she's planning a shopping spree by hitting Leaf It Out's website.
I haven't met these florists. There's absolutely nothing on this website at all that would inspire me to order an arrangement of flowers. But nonetheless, let's go ahead and let's see if we can buy online. And I've come up with Paige, currently under construction. Wonderful.
Frustrated by the unfinished website, she resorts to the phone.
Good morning, Leaf It Out.
Yeah, good morning. I wonder if you can help me, please.
Leaf It Out have a page offering novelty floral arrangements, and one in particular has caught dog lover Hilary's eye.
Would it be possible to order an arrangement of flowers that I could collect later today?
Yeah,
good.
Yeah, what type of arrangement would you like?
I would really like the dog if you could do it. How much would that be?
Right, that's
£75. Okay, thank you so much.
Yeah,
thank
bye
you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. I would say £75 is too cheap. It's crystal clear that these people are not in it for business. And it's my job to make sure that they are.
Back in Milton Keynes and unaware the order just in is from the business inspector, Donna is off to the local wholesalers. But she's already forgotten which doggy she has on her own website.
So you're going for the sitting?
No, the standing, she said.
Standing?
She?
Yeah.
I should just take her a picture, actually, and send it to her. Say, this one. That's what I'll do. I don't know what we did without phone camera phones. Hello, it's me. Did you get my picture? Oh, I couldn't remember if you said the sitting or the standing one. That's what I thought. That's the standing one. It's the sitting down one, isn't it?
An hour later, and Donna, with Hillary's dog, returns to the shop.
She not the same one. She liked that dog with the nose.
Yeah, that's the same one.
No, it's not.
Why not?
Totally different.
That'd be fine, though, because we can do its eyes the same. Still have the collar.
Yeah.
It's a dog.
Leaving her mansion behind, Hillary heads to the outskirts of Milton Keynes, where she'll meet her budding florists to pick up her order. So far, she's been underwhelmed by the broken website and bargain basement prices.
I'm a little surprised to see a florist shop in such a location as this. I would imagine that they don't get a lot of passing trade here.
And close up, the florist's is even more disappointing.
I'm just looking at this here, empty, dusty. It's hardly the image of a florist, really. What they should have in this window is flowers.
What the girls don't know is that they're about to come face to face with the business inspector. And she can already smell trouble.
Hello, hi, I'm Hillary.
And I'm your business angel.
Oh, hi, I'm Donna, nice to meet
Hello, Donna.
You.
Hi.
Hello,
nice You're to meet Anne. You, I'm Anne. Hi, Anne.
Pleased to meet you.
Yeah. Good. Well, he looks gorgeous, I've got to say. He's fabulous. Oh, he's big, isn't he?
He is, yeah.
How long did it take you to make this?
Between us, about an hour and a half.
Yeah, probably.
Probably about an hour and a half between us.
And do you know how much it's cost you to make this?
Ourselves?
Yeah.
Roughly, it's cost us about £40, roughly.
Roughly. How roughly?
Well...
And what have you taken into account for that £40?
The actual... The spray.
Yeah.
All the flowers that have gone into it.
Yeah.
The actual base.
Yeah.
The bits of oasis that we've added.
Yeah.
And the things like these.
So you've no labour and you've no fixed costs or overheads into it. Basically,
no.
But the cost is £40.
The cost is, yeah.
Right.
The girls have no idea how to price for profit, and soon Hillary's going to be digging even deeper.
So we're going to meet tomorrow and go through last year's accounts.
Yes.
And your next year's accounts.
Okay.
I'll see you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye, girls. Bye. I bet you all the money in the world it's cost more than £40 to make that. They clearly haven't got a clue, but it'll be a pleasure to help them. And I hope they listen. Well, I'll make them listen.
Next, Hillary makes a discovery that has her seeing red.
He's bloody irresponsible of you.
And another small business gets a grilling.
Get it wrong, and believe me, it will finish you.
Hillary DeVay, the business inspector, has put aside her day job to help two small businesses carve out a successful future.
I'm excited about going into these businesses because I know I can help them. I know I can help them turn it around.
Next up for scrutiny is Warwickshire-based event planner Gary Martin. For the past 19 years, he's created crazy props, from pirates to mirror balls, for themed nights to remember.
If you want us to send you an email with a load of... Western props on it, we can do.
Now Gary thinks he's created a show-stopping idea that could take the events world by storm.
Every single table at an event has a space in the middle of it that isn't used, and we've come up with a way of using that space at every event to create something pretty spectacular. So flick that onto changing colour. Look at that for a very cool table centre.
Like millions of small businesses, Gary works from home. Sister Julie keeps the books, running a tight ship, while Gary strives to make their fortune with his flashy table centres.
I'd love to make the company bigger, but what does concern me is I'm moving into areas that I don't completely understand.
In the time Gary's taken to get his company into first gear, Hillary's grown her small business into a multi-million pound empire. She spotted a gap in the traditionally male-dominated world of haulage, filled it, and made a killing. Today, Hillary's at her head office, and intrigued by Gary's flashy table centres, she's got a plan to see him and them in action.
I invited Gary here today under the pretense I'm holding a retirement dinner for a long-standing member of staff this evening. So he doesn't know that it's a ploy for me to get to see his product.
Gary's packed up his lights in Warwick, and unbeknownst to him, he's heading for Hillary.
I think they're going to like these table tennis. They found us on the internet, but we've never done anything from before, so I think they'll be quite pleased with what we're going to do for them.
I'm interested to see how his business works, but just seeing his vehicle now from a branding and marketing perspective, it's not very distinguished.
If Gary wants his product to have mass appeal, the business inspector believes he'll need a brand that stands out from the rest. Gary better hopes she likes his lights better.
I'm undercover today, so as far as he's concerned, this is just a prospective venue that he's setting his wares up in.
We've got two different sizes of mirror balls, but it's quite nice to vary the heights of them, I think, because it fills the room up a little bit more. We did a similar thing with fish bowls, and these ones particularly are pretty good with footballs on the top. Really excellent for places that do sports. Great for that.
It's Hillary's first chance to see Gary's table centres up close.
I think they're absolutely fabulous. I really like it. And I'd certainly have them at my next function.
Duffy looks really nice, I think. And it's, hello.
Hello. I just thought I'd come and say hello.
Hello.
It's going to look really good, isn't it?
Yeah. Do you want me to show you with the lights out?
Yeah, go on. Yeah, that'd be great.
You've got to leave some on for people to see to eat.
So, really, really good. Oh. And they change colour, do they?
You can either have them set on one colour, you can choose a colour, or you can have them all fading colour. People quite like it because it's sort of something a bit different.
Well, it's different, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, I like them. Excellent.
Good.
All right. Thanks
then.
Very much.
No problem. Who's that then?
Gary will find out soon enough. The next time he sees Hillary will be at her home, where he'll find out if she thinks his business is ready to go to the next level. Hillary DeBay's hard graft has paid off. In 15 years, she's gone from living above a chip shop to a sumptuous country pile. And today, florists Leaf It Out are about to get a taste of how life could be.
Wow, look at that. That's very nice.
Very impressive house. It looks a bit like a stately home.
Hillary's summoned them for a reason. She already knows their pricing is out, but now she's had a close inspection of the books, she's horrified.
On a turnover of 20,000, they've actually managed to lose £11,630. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. They've lost 50% of over 50% of the turnover.
Oh, God, it's a big knot.
Hi.
Hello.
Thank you.
Wow.
Hello.
How are you? All right.
Hi, nice to meet you again.
Hi, nice to meet you again.
Yeah. I'm fine, thank you.
You did. What a lovely house.
Quite a nice spot, isn't it?
It's
lovely.
So come on, let's sit down.
Today is not a day for social niceties. Right. It's straight down to business.
Where to start? Do you know what your accounts read last year? Your year ends the 31st of March, isn't it?
Is it the 5th of April, isn't it?
No, your year end, 5th of April is the tax year.
Is it?
Your actual financial year end as a business is the 31st of March. Why didn't you know that?
I don't know, actually.
Right, what did you think when you saw the accounts?
Well, we've only briefly looked at them because...
You haven't looked at them? See, I find that incredible. As a business person, I find that absolutely incredible. If you continue to trade as you currently are, your losses this year will be £14,500. To me, and I'm going to be absolutely brutal with you here, it's bloody irresponsible of you. Totally irresponsible. Now, who's funding these losses?
Us.
Well, how? How are you funding them?
Well, we have help from relatives. Probably my mum and her brother.
So it's bank of mum and brother?
Yes.
To me, I hate that. I absolutely hate it. You've got a duty to yourselves, to your families, you know, to make sure you are running a profitable business. And like I say, now, that's the bad news. The good news is you've done it that badly. It's not that difficult for you to now follow the path of righteousness and get it right. Florists generally, nationwide, are working on gross profit margins of between 32 and 37%. You're working on a gross profit margin of 11%. So for instance, that arrangement yesterday, straight away, somebody asked you for one of them. Rule of the thumb, double your cost of your flowers.
But fixing the pricing is the easy bit. They don't have enough customers and need regular work they can bank on.
Identify possible venues that you could be supplying to.
Yeah.
If we get one commercial contract that generates £100 a week, you know, all this is totally achievable. It's not pie in the sky, it's simple, piece of cake. Whilst family members are funding the business and just keep bailing them out, I mean, if you think about it, there could have been another £7,000 in each home of surplus income if they'd not had that business. They could have actually both had a blinking good holiday, couldn't they?
It's been a damning assessment of Leaf It Out, but the girls seem as chirpy as ever.
This is good for us, isn't it?
Yeah, and I think really we're looking forward to the challenge because, you know, we've never shied away from a challenge. Everything that we've ever done has been a challenge. So it's just a new set of challenges. It's a new day.
Yeah.
We'll start again.
Next to enter the business inspector's lair is Table Centre creator Gary Martin. Hillary scrutinised his accounts and they're in great shape, a strong base from which to think bigger. He's turning over £450,000 a year, and now Gary wants help taking his business nationwide.
Hello, Gary.
Hello.
We meet again. I'm your business expert.
Very nice to meet you.
Again.
Excellent.
Come on and sit down over here.
I think you've a good product.
Thank you. I believe that I've got something that would work internationally. Everywhere I've been and shown people that product, because it's so different and there's not that many people doing it, people want it, you know, they do like it when they see it. It saves money, because on events, people spend a whole lot of money on lighting and other things, and that would be the thing that everybody was talking about and touching, and it's a talking point.
Convinced he's onto a winner, Gary's tried to expand by partnering up with another party planner.
We've got one licence running up in Manchester, which has been really successful. If they get a job that's up to 14, they can just handle it and go and do it. If it's any bigger than that, then they have to pull us in for the bigger jobs of 100 and 150.
Do you sell the product?